dysplasia is finally the most extreme form of adaptation, where more mature tissue cells are replaced by immature cells proliferating at a higher pace. Dysplasia isn't cancer yet, but it's actually the step before neoplasia. Its distinctive characteristics are loss of uniformity of cells, nuclear pleomorphism, mitotic figure increase, abnormal mitotic figures, and uncontrolled tissue growth. Dysplasia loss of uniformity can be identified by its model tissue, where cells have different forms and dimensions. And at this point, nuclear pleomorphism arises. Well, nuclear pleomorphism occurs with cell nuclei being different from each other and from their normal form. Their nuclear membrane is thicker, with numerous nucleoli and chromatins being dispersed due to the higher cell differentiation process. Mitotic figures, which are normally extremely rare in tissues, increase in the number of dysplastic tissues. In these tissues, mitotic figures are instead quite common, as well as abnormal mitotic figures, just like the tripolar spindles. Moreover, uncontrolled tissue growth that doesn't have a differentiation order takes place. Looking at the epithelium, we would normally see a basal layer of immature cells and a top layer of differentiated cells. But in dysplasia, this division does not exist. Undifferentiated cells, in fact, may go up in the epithelium and find themselves in different layers. At the same time, differentiation may take place anywhere downwards. A well-known example of dysplasia is that of the uterine cervix, the so-called cervix intraepithelial neoplasia. In this case, the undifferentiated cells of the basal layer progressively replace those of the various epithelial layers. So, for example, the epithelium may only be composed of undifferentiated cells, with maybe a single superficial layer slightly differentiated. Grading of this condition is given by a three-level scale. CIN1 refers to condition where basal cells involve the basal third of the epithelium. CIN2 refers to basal undifferentiated cells in about two-thirds of the epithelial layer, as in this case. While CIN3 refers to a condition where the entire epithelium is composed of undifferentiated cells. If in CIN3, we can talk about in situ carcinoma, a real cancer that hasn't started to invade other areas yet. In the same way squamous dysplasia of the bronchi, developing in a pre-existing squamous metaplasia, manifests with a tissue dedifferentiation. The most undifferentiated epithelial cells, similar to basal cells, do not form in the lower layer but go up to over half of the epithelium. Thank you for watching. This video was created by School of Biomedical Sciences Agora. We hope you enjoyed it. If you're curious or have any doubt or question, please feel free to leave a comment below. If you want to find out more about us or want to support our project, click on the following link to visit our website.